We have possibilities. So somebody is following their dreams. This could be looking at other possibilities, or they're realizing there's possibilities out there. This is someone who is starting to believe in their self and they're moving forward in life. This could also be someone that's being guided to move forward, to, you know, view other possibilities or look at other possibilities in life other than what they're doing now. It's like somebody have made up their mind and they're moving forward. This is someone who wants to be happy. This could be someone who also have been in a phase of healing, and now they're finally able to move forward after taking a break, taking out the time to retreat and release what no longer serves purpose in their life. Now you have wishful thinking. So whoever this person is, this is someone who definitely wants a second chance. It's like they're wanting to reunite, reconnect. This could be a reconciliation between two people. Yeah, somebody is living their life in the now. I just seen Smell the Roses. We have Cutting Ties. So this could be someone that you've moved on from. If this was certain people or a certain person that you've cut ties with, it's like you've set yourself free from something. And you're only focused on what's going on now moving forward. You're not focused on the past. This person is realizing this and they feel hopeless. This could be someone who feels lost. They feel depressed. Because they see that you've completely cut ties. They also view you as someone that's awakened. They feel like you're standing up for yourself. Maybe this person is someone who felt like they were able to walk all over you. And they always thought there would be a second chance. But they're realizing this was wishful thinking. Because you've completely moved forward. You've moved towards happiness. You've moved towards healing. And now you're at peace. You're looking at other possibilities in life. You're following your dreams. And you've completely made up your mind. This is someone who did not expect for you to see your worth and believe in yourself. This was definitely a lesson, a karmic lesson. It could have been a karmic cycle that you were in and a certain person that you were attached to. They just felt like they would always repeat this cycle with you. Now that you're out of this cycle, you've chose to heal and move forward. They're stuck in that same cycle feeling hopeless. Because you've learned whatever lessons it was that you needed to learn, but they haven't. So everything is like overwhelming to this person. Because they're faced with things that they didn't expect to, you know, have to deal with ever in life. If these are wounds that they need to heal, a lot of things that they've done in the past, it's coming back to haunt them. They never thought would come back to haunt them. It's like the only thing this person was looking forward to was repeating a cycle with you until you cut ties with this person. Yeah, and set boundaries. This is someone that was very disrespectful. And as I said, this person felt like they could walk all over you. It's like you had to show this person better than you could tell this person. If this was like a back and forth, this person could be someone that likes to fight. They like to argue. You had to draw the line. You had to defend yourself. Stand up for yourself. And that's something they never expected for you to do. you're disappointed. This is someone who is heartbroken because they never thought they would have to face their actions. It's like this person is being faced with divine intervention. And they don't like it. Their actions are hurting them right now. It's causing a lot of emotional pain and sorrow. And it has them it has them wanting to, it's like, it's something that they didn't want to do, but it's like forcing this person to do self-reflecting, look at the things that they need to change in life in order to be able to move forward, in order to get out of this energy of feeling lost. And these are just things that are hard for this person because they didn't expect to have to do this. If this person is someone that wanted to blame you for their actions or the reason why things are not going right in their life, they could no longer blame you. It's like they have to go deep within and they just don't want to. So it's a lot of pressure on this person. And it's like, this is someone who knows you're not the reason why they're going through what they're going through. They know it's their actions, the things that they chose to do, bad choices that they've made. But they don't want to face it. And this is why they're keeping their self in this energy of hurt, emotional pain, feeling lost, feeling depressed. It's like they don't want to change. And they're mad at you because you chose to change and want more for yourself and want more out of life. You chose to keep an open mind and follow movement in your life, forward movement, instead of being stagnant or feeling lost with this person. You could have felt lost while you were attached to this person. You could have felt stagnant, like things weren't moving forward for you. Now you're not around this person. They're out of your energy. You're no longer feeling this way, but they are. Yeah. You have storm warning. So this person definitely felt betrayed. When you chose to stand up for yourself, defend yourself, draw the line, they felt betrayed and they tried to create a storm. A lot of drama, a lot of chaos, a lot of conflict because you were seeing your worth. You started believing in yourself. You started seeing what you deserve out of life. And you realized you deserve better than what you were receiving or what you were going through or allowing with this person. Yeah, you have ghosted, breakup, and signs and synchronicities. So I'm getting, this was definitely like a relationship. After a relationship ended, this person could have had something to do with another person ghosting you. It's like they wanted you to feel rejected. So they created a lot of drama. They created a lot of chaos around you. This could be to make other people uninterested in you. It's like they wanted you to feel like they were your only option. But you were receiving a lot of messages from the universe at this time. So whatever they were trying to do, it didn't confuse you. It was only confirmation that you made the right decision to move forward. And believe in yourself. Because this person had been testing you the entire time you were attached to this person. They're a karmic partner. So whatever they chose to do with this storm, you've seen it as a test. Especially if you learned whatever lesson you needed to learn from this person. You've seen it as a test. This is something that they would normally do. It wasn't something that was new. But in their mind, they felt like they were going to like keep people away from you, get people to reject you and ignore you. Yeah, this is someone who, if they weren't happy, they didn't want you to be happy. And they felt like you were in this energy. Happy, at peace, harmony. They weren't. Yeah, and they felt like it was only a matter of time before you manifest new love. Before you chose to move forward and start a new beginning. This is someone who honestly thought if they created a storm in your life, you would just, it's like you would give them a second chance. You wouldn't be able to believe in yourself and see that you deserve better. This is what they honestly thought. Like, this is the type of person that lived their life in the energy of hurt people, hurt people. But you're not that type of person. You would rather move on from a person before you project hurt or pain onto someone. You would rather pull your energy back. And you are being guided to. These are things that you were supposed to do. This is why you're happy. But this person is not. This is why they're being faced with a lot of things they didn't expect to be faced with. It's like they're learning karmic lessons too. And you're not someone that taught this person a karmic lesson. They taught you a karmic lesson. This is someone who was supposed to challenge you on your journey. And this is to help your soul's growth. They didn't know this would be the outcome. Now they feel like it's even 10 times harder for them to move forward because they have not been challenged. You choosing to set boundaries and draw the line is a major challenge for them. But it's helping this person to learn whatever lesson that they need to learn. Because you just couldn't teach them the type of lessons that they taught you. You're not the type of person that fight fire with fire. So them intentionally choosing to hurt you, they're realizing the hurt that they caused for you, the pain that they caused for you that you've released and healed, they're being faced with it. Now that you're no longer in their energy, they're no longer allowed in your energy. They feel blocked off, but having to face their own demons, the same demons they tried to project onto you, and they felt like they would keep you bound to that energy and you would always feel like, hey, I need to give that person a second chance. And it's like this flower on this card, it's this symbol, I thought it was a merry-go-round. That's how it kind of looked. It's like that person wanted you to keep going in circles with them. But you finally set yourself free. And you set yourself free by doing a lot of reflecting, looking at things that you need to change, things that you need to heal. Because you weren't seeing a change in the connection that you were in with this person. So you had to be that change in order to move forward. It's like you had to solve the problem. A problem that they never expected for you to solve. Yeah. We have secret crush, a love interest. I was just looking at this ghosted card and I was thinking whoever the person is that ghosted you was the right person, but it was the wrong time. You have secret crush and love interest. This person is someone who, they were very focused on you. So if they ghosted you, they never stopped focusing on you. They're watching you from afar. This is someone who has always admired you. And if they ghosted you, they felt like that time wasn't the right time for them to approach you or try to develop a connection with you. So they just distanced themselves, especially if they seen that you were setting boundaries in life and you chose to distance yourself. They didn't think they would get caught. So whoever this person is that you drew the line with, this was definitely a karmic partner. They didn't expect to get caught. They never expected for you to see them for who they truly are. It's like you start seeing this person crystal clear. There was no more denying the red flags, the signs that you were getting from the universe about this person. Like, you had to take action and move on, move forward, make a change in order to see a change. Somebody wants forgiveness. This is definitely whoever this karmic partner is. This could have been a toxic child's mother or father. This person feels like nobody compares to you. This could be someone who felt like they would be able to find another you. They would be able to find someone else to go back and forth with them, to put up with whatever. I'm hearing project their energy on. They felt like they would be able to find someone else to project their energy on, but they can't find another you. It's like this person is running into people that are like them. People that are lessons to them. Karmic lessons, because they're still in that toxic karmic cycle, not realizing they would never be able to find another you. They're only going to run into people that's going to mirror their energy and challenge them to do some self-reflecting, make some changes that need to be made. Yeah, you have a jealous friend. So there's a jealous friend that could have been involved with trying to create some type of storm with your ex. They only wanted your money. So yeah, this is someone who could have knew that this person was using you. But they still could have been in cahoots with this ex. Yeah, we have inspiration, awareness. So maybe there was something that you became aware of, or this person does not like the fact that you're aware. You're someone who has definitely made a life change. You're cutting ties where they need to be cut. You're standing up for yourself. You've went through an awakening, and your inspiration to other people. That intimidated whoever this jealous friend is. This is someone who often, you know, likes people to feel sorry for them. This was definitely a karmic friend. So they're in the same energy as this karmic partner. It wasn't hard for them to partner up with that person. But whatever they did do, it backfired. And they can't believe it. I'm hearing a fake friend. This is someone who, if you chose to cut this person off before you cut that person off, they were behind the scenes moving funny. And they didn't expect for you to cut them off. This is some, I'm hearing two-faced it. This is someone that's two-faced it. Now we have, how do you feel about me? So somebody wants to know how do you feel about them. This could be the secret crush. So we have heartbroken and then unconditional love. So whoever the secret crush is, this could be someone who they feel like them ghosting you, or this could be ignoring you. They could have just cut off all communication. They feel like this is something that hurt you, with heartbroken being here. They view you as someone that loves unconditionally. You have that toxic cycle is over. And then you have Cancer. You could be a Cancer. One of these people could be a Cancer. I'm also getting this karmic partner is heartbroken because you're someone that loves unconditionally. Now, whatever it is that they did to you and you've moved past, they're forced to face. Because they have to face it in order to change the energy that they're in and move forward. That toxic cycle is over for you. And it breaks their heart because in order to heal, they have to face whatever it is that have been hurting them. Yeah, they're going through karma. Now, whoever this secret admirer, secret crush energy is, they have something to tell you. This could be someone who is wanting to reach out after ghosting you. They're wanting to say something to you. The Three of Wands. This is someone who have, it's like they chose to distance their self, as I say, because of whatever you were going through. This is someone who, it's like they didn't want to add on to whatever it is that you were going through. This could be someone who felt like they were not going to bring any positivity to the situation or something like that. This is someone who also feels like your efforts are paying off. You're someone that is going to come out successful, or they just knew, with the Three of Wands being here, they held back because they knew that something would be a positive outcome for you. But they've also sat back and watched your growth. They see the progress that you've made, and this could be inspiration for them. Yeah, it's like now they're aware of something. This could be you inspired someone. You've made them aware of the things that they need to change or they need to reflect on. So that's why they felt like, or that's why it was the right person, wrong time. Even though there was some type of obstacle that took place to keep that person away from you, to keep everybody away from you. This could be to get everybody to turn against you. That didn't work. Somebody was inspired by you. Whoever this person is, this is your person. This is someone that you have a partnership with. Yeah, we have the Three of Cups. Yeah, it's like somebody is happy about your progress. They could be celebrating or they're wanting to celebrate with you. This person could be someone that's a friend. Someone that wants to be more than friends with the Three of Cups. We have the Four of Swords. So this could be a friendship that was laid to rest. They're viewing this person that you are no longer attached to as a third party. It's like they found out something. If this is your person, they found out that you're their person, or you found out this person is your person that ghosted you. If this is someone that knows your karmic partner, they chose to lay the situation to rest. They chose to kind of like cut ties with this person as well. Yeah, it's like they've completely moved forward. Now, this could be a situation where whoever your karmic partner is, they knew your person because they were in the same friend circle. Three of Cups. But they've laid the situation to rest. They've put an end to whatever they were doing with this person. If they met this person through another friend or something like that, they just ended out this Three of Cups, this friendship. And they chose to move on from that person. This is someone that's moving forward in life as well. It's like they're setting themselves free. We have the Page of Cups. So this is an apology that's coming to you. It's like not only did they ghost you because they felt like they didn't want to be in the middle, or they felt like they wouldn't be able to add to anything, or whatever it is that you were going through, they didn't want to come toward you and try to develop a connection then. They just felt like it wouldn't be a positive thing to do. But they do want to apologize for ghosting you, because you've been a big inspiration to this person. You've helped them to move on. You've helped them to set their self free. But it's like time to retreat was needed. They needed time to retreat. You needed time to retreat if this is your person. Because typically, you and your person are in the same toxic cycle. But you're not meant to come together in that toxic cycle, reunite in that toxic cycle. So things are going to constantly happen where they ghost you. You ghost them. It's not going to be the right time. Until you move on from the patterns that keeps you stagnant in life. It prevents you from moving forward in life. So I'm getting both you and that person needed to clear your mind, clear your energy in order to be able to take a leap of faith. Set yourself free. Now that they've done this and they see that you've done the same thing, you've learned whatever lessons you needed to learn, they're wanting to apologize for their actions. They feel like they acted way too quick, or they just weren't thinking, but everything happened for a reason. Now, there could be more things that took place between you and this person. They could have been very immature about the way that they acted in the past, and this is why they're wanting to apologize. It could have been, as I say, more to it. They feel like they acted without thinking. And now they're wanting to apologize. You have the Knight of Cups. And then you have the Two of Swords in the reverse. So yeah, this is someone who just... they were trying to avoid you. This is someone who, if they acted a certain way towards you and it was very immature... This could have been playing mind games with you. They didn't want you to confront them. And they kind of just distanced themselves. And I'm getting, you're someone who did not choose to. It's like you're not the type of person that's going to project energy onto a person. You don't project your pain and hurt on other people. And maybe this is what your person was accustomed to. They didn't get that energy from you because you were too busy focusing on healing. You were too busy focusing on retreating. Doing a lot of self-reflecting and making those changes that you wanted to see in your life. And this definitely inspired them. They need to do the same. Because that was something that was new to them. Instead of you projecting your energy onto them or getting angry, you inspired them. You made them aware of their behavior, their actions. And that spoke volumes to them. This has helped them to set their self free. If they operated more out of their ego, they're no longer doing this. This is someone who is just not the same person. Yeah, you have the Ace of Pentacles and the Page of Swords. They're still keeping tabs on you because they're wanting to come towards you to start over. And you have the Ten of Wands and the Tower. Wow. And it's like whoever this karmic partner is, they're watching you as well. And it's like this new beginning that's coming towards you with the Ace of Pentacles. This is definitely going to be a lot to carry for that person. Because as I explained, they can't find another you. They were counting on repeating a toxic cycle with you. This is someone who is not willing to face the things that they need to change. This is why when this happens, it's going to create a tower. But it's going to be so much going on. So much coming back all at one time. With the Ten of Wands, they're going to feel weighed down and burdened, overwhelmed. Yeah, we have the Three of Pentacles. This person is someone who, they could have also had other people helping them. It's like whoever this jealous friend is, this could be these two people. They're watching you. They're both going to be going through this tower. Or if it was more people, if this was like a team effort, three or more people, all of these people are going to be weighed down. Because they didn't know they were sitting back, waiting. Hold on one second. Yeah, it's like they positioned themselves to sit back and wait for this sudden change to happen in your life. And this is a new beginning, a drastic change. These people came together to set you back. They wanted you to feel overwhelmed and burdened. But all of a sudden, you ended out of cycle. Now all of these people are blocked off from you. Yeah, they're faced with their own challenges. Everything that they wanted to project onto you, they're being faced with. And it's too much to bear. So we have the King of Swords. Now, this could be someone that's like an authority figure. If these people came together behind the scenes to do something illegal, the justice system could be involved. Like, these people could be being investigated with the Hermit and the King of Swords, and then you have the Eight of Swords. So somebody could have gotten caught doing something. This was something illegal, and they didn't expect to get caught. Somebody could be going to jail. somebody has definitely gotten caught, and there's been an ongoing investigation. They have journey. It's a good thing that you chose to move forward and move on from whoever these people are. Yeah. You've cleared your pathway. We have distant horizons. So whatever took place that they've gotten caught up in, could be one of these people, could be both, could be a group of people that was working with this ex, or it could be a group of people that was working with a jealous friend. Take it where it resonates. Whatever they did, they thought they would get away with it. They would be able to distance themselves from it. Yeah, but somebody is literally dealing with a legal situation. Now, this could be a situation where there could be false accusations that was made against you by an ex, and they had different people helping them, and they felt like this would have you and them back together. That didn't work. Somebody is investigating some type of lies. If this was the situation where you were done wrong, there was something injustice done to you involving a legal situation, there's an investigator here, and somebody has gotten caught up. Whoever thought that they would get away with this, they're dealing with a court situation, and now they're concerned. Yeah, could be other people that was working with this person. They're concerned with toil and labor. Yeah, there were definitely hidden motives behind the storm that this person tried to create after you've learned whatever lessons you needed to learn from them and you walked away. This is why your person felt blocked off from you and they felt the need to ghost you. It's like they knew something was coming or something was getting ready to happen, but they just didn't know at that time what it was. It's like they didn't know they were preparing themselves. And you were definitely preparing yourself, or you were well prepared of for whatever it is that took place, because you were still able to move forward. You had a lot of foresight. You knew this person was someone that likes to project. They like to fight. They like to argue. They like to create obstacles. And you knew this was confirmation you were making the right decision. A destined partnership. So yeah, this is a destined partnership that you share with the person that ghosted you. Whoever these people are that came together to create burdens for you, this is why they got caught. This is why they're under judgment and going through some type of unexpected karma, and they're concerned. Yeah, these are their lessons. We have abundance. You're someone that is going to be very abundant. They've been hiding their emotions. So your person, they've been hiding how they truly feel. I got a tarot card reading on you. They're in deep regret for how they treated you. So yeah, there was much more that took place other than them just ghosting you. And they're in regret. This is why they're wanting to apologize for their actions. Because it's like they were faced with karma as well, but not in the way that they expected. The karma they received was inspiration from you, and it made them aware of their actions. It made them aware that they needed to change. And that was like a challenge for them because they weren't accustomed to it. Like you ended up teaching your person a lesson that they needed to learn. because whatever they did to you, you didn't have to project it onto them. It's like they projected it onto their self, and they were well aware of their actions when it came to you. That was a first for them. Hold on a second. Everything was supposed to backfire. All of the deception that was done to you. Yeah, because you chose equal give and take. I want equal give and take. You chose to stand up for yourself and not continue to put up with whatever you were going through, whatever you were tolerating in, not just this karmic partner, but everybody in that toxic cycle. You have manipulation. So yeah, anybody that have manipulated you, deceived you, they're going through karma. They're being faced with their actions, no matter who it was. Whoever your person is, they've been gaining the strength to say something. For a long time, they could have been in the energy of not knowing what to say, not knowing how to reconnect with you. Yeah, they definitely want to start over fresh. This is the only thing that's on their mind. It's starting over fresh and getting a new opportunity with you. It's like they're ready for a new beginning. They're ready to start over. And they've been praying to God for this connection. You know, they were afraid of rejection, so they acted a certain way toward you because they were afraid of rejection. But I'm hearing they're not the same person. This person have changed. You're constantly on their mind. They're constantly being reminded of you throughout the day. This is someone who wants to kiss you. This could be what they're thinking about, daydreaming about. They want you and they won't take no for an answer. This is someone who wants to make love to you. And they've learned their karmic lessons as well. They communicate with you telepathically. And because of you, they've had a spiritual awakening. So whatever you've done in life to shift your energy to be the change that you want to see, it has helped your person in a positive way. It has inspired them and made them aware of things that they feel like nobody else could make them aware of to help them change. So this is a positive outcome after in and out of toxic cycle. This is a cycle that is finally over. And it's only a matter of time before your person come towards you and say what's in their heart. Say whatever it is that they've been hiding.